Hi, fourth grade. So last video for the week on area model. So today is four digits by one digit. So obviously four digit numbers look like this. There is a digit in the ones place, the tens place, the hundreds place, and the thousands place. That gives you a four digit number. So we're going to do a couple of examples. So like we talked about earlier, it is the exact same process, except instead of a rectangle that has two slots or three slots, you have four. So remember, before you can decide how to separate your boxes, you have to be able to take this number and turn it into an expanded form number. So our math problem is going to be 1,291 times 7. So obviously the 7 is going to go over here because it's going to multiply by everything on top. So if I go from right to left, starting in the ones place, I know that this box is going to be the smallest because it is the smallest digit. Then my next box, which is a 9 in the tens place, is going to be 90. And then my next box is a 2 in the hundreds place, which is going to be 200, which means my box compared to the 90 is going to be slightly bigger. And then our last one is a 1 in the thousands place, which is 1,000. And just remember that everything on top, these numbers, they don't multiply by each other. They are only multiplying by this number over here. So again, I like to remind myself that I am multiplying by putting a multiplication sign on the edge. So here we go. So I can do my little trick that I did yesterday and the day before by looking at how many zeros that I have. And I have three, so there's going to be three zeros down here. And there's a comma. I don't want to forget that. So now that I've used these three zeros, I can look at numbers that I know. 7 times 1. I know that is 7. So 7 times 1,000 is 7,000. So I'm done here. And I circle it just because I like to know that I'm finished. Then I move over to the next box. That's 200. There's two zeros there. So I'm going to bring those down. And I'm done. And now I'm going to take 7 times 2. And I know in my head that that's 14. But don't forget, every three numbers, 1, 2, 3, there's a comma. So 200 times 7 is 1,400. Now I'm going to move to the tens place. There's a 90. So again, 1, 0. And then I cross it off. And then 9 times 7, we know, is 63. And I'm done with that one. 90 times 7, 630. And the last one, there's a 1 in the ones place. So that means it is 1 times 7, which is 7. So now I have to take my four numbers that I figured out and I have to add them together. And again, it is so important that we are lining these up as neatly as possible. So 7,000, then we have 1,400 or 1,400. Then we have 630, and then we have 7. So remember, I sometimes put these little plus signs up top because it reminds me that I have to add everything in these boxes together. Be very careful. There's three zeros and then a 7, two zeros and then a 3. Then I have 0, 4 plus 6, that's 10. Remember, I have to carry if it's over 9 over here, 7 plus 1, 8. 8 plus 1, 9. So our product of 1,291 using area model, we found that it is 9,037. So things that are important to remember. Step 1, you can draw your box. Step 2, take your number and put it into expanded form. That's what each box is going to have right here. Step 3, put your other number on the side because we are multiplying digits by 1. And then go slowly and think, what is the product of the number on top and the number on the side? And just keep going. Then, final step, add them all together, and there's your product. Have a great day, fourth grade. Good luck.